દરેક પ્રસંગોમાં.
ઇન એવરી સિચ્યુએશન, ઇફ યુ લુક એટ નિરુમાસ બોલ્ડનેસ, હર ફિયરલેસનેસ, ધ પાવર શી હેડ વાઇલ ટેકિંગ બિગ ડિસિઝન્સ, યેટ ધેર વોઝ નો ઈગો, શી હેડ સ્પિરિચ્યુઅલ ડિગ્નિટી ઓર કુમારી, શી વોઝ એબલ ટુ ડૂ સચ કોલોસલ વર્ક ફોર વર્લ્ડ સલ્વેશન ફિયરલેસલી. વી ગોટ ટુ વિટનેસ ધીસ ઇન જાત્રાસ એન્ડ ઓન મેની અધર ઓકેઝન્સ.
She had no fear about being disrespected, even in situations where she was openly insulted. Secondly, when her health deteriorated and she was about to leave her mortal body, there was not the slightest of fear to be seen in her. Thirdly, in matters of Dada's projects, she did not have the slightest of fear. And fourthly, even though she had a female body, she was not affected by it. We could see that she did not have the tuber of fear in her.
Whom are we worshipping? We are worshipping the Tirthankar lords. We are worshipping the Gnanis. So then how can we be timid like this? How can we succumb to karma? The karma are powerless and we are the self, the absolute self.
She started this way. Where should I travel to? I should travel to places where Dada has never been. She would tell us that in the jeep that she would travel in, there would be 25 men around and Niruma would be the only woman. She would be all alone. At that time, there was no one traveling with her. She would go to villages, do satsangs and return back at night. When we would ask her, Niruma, why are you not scared? She would say, I don't know what it was. But I have so much faith in Dada. Dada is with me. The Lord of the 14 worlds is with me. So I would never have any such thoughts. There were riots. Riots had broken out here.
Yes.
Riots between the Hindus and the Muslims.
And we could see them from the Dada Darshan building. There were shootings and people were vandalizing things. Niruma was living alone at that time. She would spend her day all alone, but she had no fear or suffering.
Yes. When we were staying there in Dada Darshan on the third floor, Pujashri, you wouldn't be there sometimes. It would be just Niruma and I sometimes. When we would look out of the window, we could see people killing each other.
It was gruesome.
We could hear the gunshots. However, when it was Niruma's bedtime, she would go to sleep peacefully chanting, I am pure soul, without being bothered by anything. I would feel ashamed of myself at that time. Look at Niruma, how fearless is she, how calmly she is sleeping, even when there is so much fighting going on outside.
Killings.
When people were being killed outside, whereas even though I am a man, I was scared, and I would share this with Niruma. Niruma would say, silly boy. What's going to happen outside of Vyavasthit? And we are the self. What can anyone do to us? Moreover, Dada is with us. She would say this. Even in Jatra, during all our Jatras, there were problems. When the attacks on Babri Masjid had happened, she told everyone, everyone stay with Niruma, nothing will happen to anyone. This was such a huge responsibility she took on. Then in Calcutta, we had to walk in the curfew. Niruma said, it'll be fine, just do Asim Jai Jaikar, do Asim Jai Jaikar. My intellect just could not accept this. How will it be fine when there were shoot on sight orders in the curfew? But we all reached safely. Everything ended well. She would pray to Dada in every jatra. There were a few occasions when there were huge insults hurled at Niruma. Tremendous insults. I got a chance to see Niruma's steadiness because I was sitting right outside. After it all ended, I told Niruma, Niruma, even though there was so much said to you, there was not the slightest change in the expression on your face. Niruma, how is that? Niruma replied, did you see it? Maintain such steadiness. Don't get disturbed. What can anyone do? You are indeed the self. So what is going to happen? She would say, no matter what unfolds, we don't let it touch us within. No negative thoughts arise within us at all. No sort of a doubt arises within us. And no matter what the other person says, I think, has Dada said this? If it is Dada who has said it, then I will definitely follow it, 100%. Then I will not even think about it. If it is someone else who has said it, I will give my view on it. If needed, I will do some pratikraman, but I'll definitely not get affected by it. Meaning, I don't get affected by the effects of insults that arise. So if I have to meet the same person tomorrow, then I don't have the fear that what if he insults me again? What if I get insulted? In the beginning, for a long time, the satsangs were not aired on television, and so people were not aware. She would be respected at some places, but there were also insults at many places. Niruma would say, when we had gone to Africa, the situation was a bit insulting. However, Niruma, as per her style, told me, "Hey, take out the sheets, I am going for a shower." I told her, "Niruma, how can you take a shower after being insulted like this? I just feel like going to sleep." Niruma replied beautifully, "How can we expect to get praises everywhere? We should be prepared. If we get praises, accept them. And if we get such insults, then accept them too. We should experience both of them. Don't be afraid. It's not like I'm here for my personal gain. I'm here to do Dada's work. I am doing Dada's work. It is alright if it is not acceptable to them. I surrender it to Dada. Dada, these people are not able to accept it. I am not here to take any commission in the middle." So the reason behind her being fearless was that she had totally surrendered to Dada. There was immense faith. There was no sense of doership. It seems that because all these things were not there, there was no fear. Sometimes, she would have bad diarrhea or a terrible cough or fever. Yet, she never felt, "What will happen to me?" Towards the end, when Niruma was diagnosed with cancer, there were a lot of discussions about whether to take her to America or stay here. Niruma said, "Turn off the lights and you all decide on it. I will follow as per what everyone decides. If you tell me to stay in Vatsalya, I will do that. If you tell me to go to Mumbai, then I'll go to Mumbai. If you all say America, then I'll go to America. All of you decide. Turn the lights off and leave the room." So she didn't have the slightest of worry. Now what will happen? Where will I go? What will happen to my body? How will it be? And with the doctors would think that Niruma is a doctor herself, so they discuss with her. "This is what's happening to you." She would tell them, "Please discuss it with these people and do whatever they tell you to do. Let me be with my Dada and my Mahatmas." It was all about Dada and Mahatmas. How are Mahatmas doing? How is their health? What are they doing? She had no thoughts like, "What will happen to me? What if I die? What about this huge city?" She would say, "Dada is doing it. He will do everything." She had immense dedication, complete dedication towards Dada. So it was like her prevalence as a woman was no way to be seen. And she did not have any sort of fear, whether it was about her health or leaving her mortal body. There were so many projects of Dada. We had to make a huge payment, but there were chances that there could be a problem with the paperwork for the land. But she would keep Dada with her at all times. Then at times, Dada would say something to her from within. So at that time as well, she asked Dada, and Dada told her to go ahead. Niruma had put it beautifully then. "Dada is taking care of things. What should we do? We should maintain purity. We should keep the intent that we don't want anything at all. And then, don't be afraid. We don't want anything at all. Dada is looking over us. We want to work with purity. And then, don't be afraid. Keep doing the work." So it can be understood at the gross level that she had such adjustments. And at the subtle level, it can be understood that doership did not arise in her. Because of these two reasons, in a lot of matters, the fear the fear that we can see in our own file one, that wasn't to be seen in her, so we can understand what a state she must be in.
It is a great, even though she had a female body complex, she had a kind of spiritual dignity. She had this beautiful science with her. Dada was with her. And she would say, I have taken Dada's Agna. I have done it with Dada's permission. So Dada will take care of it. Therefore, there won't be any problems.